Hello, namaskar all of you. This is Hanuman Jayanti, and on the occasion of Hanuman Jayanti, I intend to give a kind of online education about yoga. It is not online class. The world is very familiar with online classes, particularly with the advent of coronavirus problem all over the world. Teachers are going online to be teaching yoga. So this is certainly not teaching. This is education about yoga, a preliminary kind of education. And let me make a declaration here that this is open to anyone who is practicing yoga at any level of it. Could be a beginner or might be considering oneself to be a senior student. So this is for one and all. There will be greater advantage, however, to Iyengar clan practitioners. So this is kind of education, therefore I won't be conducting the class. Usually you are familiar with, you are asked to do some asanas. Unfortunately today yoga is doing asanas, perhaps maybe asana and pranayama, and maybe asana, pranayama and some meditation. This is what our notion of yoga is. However, when it comes to education, let me tell you here that I will not stipulate any posture for you. You can get to any posture with which you commence your session. Those are used to practicing yoga, you can settle to any position, posture with which you start your practice session. And then my instructions will be compatible to any position that you are in. Some youngsters who are bubbling with energy might be wanting to do some physical workout. They can be going for physical workout. Some of you might be very senior citizens kind of thing. And you may not be looking for exercise. You might be looking for just wellness and well-being. Whatever is the case, you can be going for that. So irrespective of any age group, this education should come good. This is what I feel anyway. Now you can embark upon any of your asana. Could be a supine position, could be a standing position with which you usually start. Now let's try to understand, these are not postures. These are not postures that you are doing. So you are settled to so-called posture. You think it is a posture. But let me tell you that this is not just a posture. Let's see how yoga comes in there. So in the preliminary stage, what you should be doing is become aware of your body, mind and breath. Because in every position, the breathing physiology changes. The way you breathe in different asanas is going to be different. So become aware of your breath and breathing, and become aware of your mind, body, breath. Now you are settled into a body position. You have taken a body position. Now merely being in the posture, it doesn't become yoga. Basically what has to be done is that you must start using whichever part of body is you are able to use in your position. If you are in standing position, you can use your limbs, you can address the limbs, you can use the arms, you can address the arms. If you are in supine position, find out which parts of the body you can be using. So use those parts of the body and also address those parts of the body. For instance, address your pelvic segment. Address the abdominal segment. Address the diaphragmatic segment. Address the chest segment. Address the upper back. Address the lower back. and which are parts of the body that you are able to address. Address those parts of your body. Then, use the various parts of the body. Find out which part of the body can be using in your posture. How much you can use your legs, how much you can use your arms, how much you can use your trunk. So find out different parts of the body, how you can be using them. So in asanas, it is not just doing. You are in a posture, now use any part of the body, every part of the body that is possible. Address any part of the body and every part of the body that is possible. Then use, address, apply the various parts of the body. Become connected between your limbs and trunk so they will be able to co-opt. So find out in your position, can you use, connect your limbs with the trunk and find out the usages. So also try to understand that in the position, if you are going to exercise, you are going to go for exalted biomechanical actions. Like if you want to exercise the body parts, you are going to go for exalted actions, that is tighten, straighten, stretch, elongate, extend, bend, rotate, pull, push, in, out, etc. So these biomechanics are going to be more exalted in case if you are going for exercise. So it can be a skeletomuscular exercise. So find out how far you can exercise your skeletomuscular body, skeletomuscular frame in your given position. And now why you are going to do that? You are also using your breath on those parts of the body. A mindful profound exhalation, a mindful profound inhalation. Then a hypernormal cycle, a sharper breathing, softer breathing, thicker breathing, thinner breathing. So make applications of your breath on your skeletomuscular body. Find out how you can be getting some benefits to corporeal body. So also your mind. Use your mind intent, your disposed condition, that you are disposed to be doing what you are doing. And bring your mind to a focus to understand your body, how you are activating your body, how the body is activated, how the body is activating. So in your exercises, you will be activating the body will be activated. So start identifying those with your mind, read those things with the mind. Will, volition, resoluteness, in certain positions you require to have will and volition quite in a pronounced way. So see that you are trying to bring in mind aspects, sensation, perception, cognition, thought process, deliberation, and then will, volition, awareness, sensitivity. So these are various functions of the mind. So see that your functions of the mind are also in place while you are in a position, what you call as a posture. Now if you are going for exercising organic body, find out any scope to exercise the organic body. Pelvic organs, abdominal organs, thoracic organs. So these are, the trunk is a location where we have our organic body situated. So find out any way for that you can be exercising your organic body, contractions, extensions, expansions, hardening, tightening, flexing, bending, rotating, whatever is in your position that you are taken in, find out all that you can be working to exercise even physiological body, organic body. So that's a body set addressal. That is called body set addressal. So we are with your body, limbs and trunk connectivity, with your breath, exhalative, inhalative, normal to hypernormal, and then mind awareness, mental functions of sensation, perception, cognition, memory, volition, will, resoluteness, intent, diligence. Find out in what way the mind can be brought in. on your corporeal body as well. So this is a body side reversal. Then in the same asana, in case if your asana is not a long duration asana, you can come up and if you need to change the sides, you can change the sides. Or you can repeat the posture once again. If some asanas are short duration asanas, like between Trikonasana and Shirshasana. Shirshasana is a long duration asana, Trikonasana is a short duration asana. So if you are in a short duration asana, you can repeat. You can change the sides on your own and follow the direction that I am giving to you. And perhaps you can repeat the same posture multiple times as well. Now, in your position, just as we go for intense body activities such as biomechanics, straightening, stretching, elongating, extending, concaving, convexing, narrowing, widening, thickening, thinning, pulling, pushing, rotating, bending, whatever is in your position coming up. So this is how you address the body. And we exercise the body, we activate the body. Similarly about the breath, see that you are trying to use a profound exhalation rather than just a normal breathing. Find out how the profound inhalation can contribute, how the profound exhalation can contribute. So hypernormal volume of breathing, then change in velocity of your breath. Normal velocity pattern to hyponormal velocity pattern, that is decelerating the breath, making it thinner, making it slower and slower and slower. On the other hand, making it hypernormal velocity of breath, that is little thicker, little sharper and little faster as well. So find out how you can be addressing the breath. So you should try to exercise the breath and breathing physiology as well by using volume of breath and velocity of breath. Thirdly, you can use confinements. The breathing of pelvic confinement to abdominal confinement to diaphragm confinement to chest confinement to even head, brain, face, skull. You can be breathing there also, because now you are not in respiratory breathing but you are in holistic breathing. So you can be using the breath, you can be exercising the breath, you can be conditioning the breath, you can be culturing the breath, even in various locations. So take avail of that as well. Then you can also exercise your mind in that position. You can exercise the will rather than merely investing will. Why don't you generate will also? Rather than having intent in your posture and position, why not generate intent? Rather than just having investment of diligence, perception, cognition, why not try to generate those? So you will have those acts also to generate will, volition, intent, diligence, perception, cognition. So the mind also can be put into exercise while your body is being exercised in that posture. So this is called mindset addressal. So there is a body set addressal where body, mind, breath work on body. There is a breath set addressal where body, mind, breath work on breath. And then of course breath has those aspects such as exhalative and inhalative. Then in the mindset addressal, the mind is addressed by body, mind, breath. So it's always a composite activity. It is a community activity. The body, mind, breath community comes together and is carrying out various activities. So this will be a kind of fabric of classical yoga, getting into your postures. Otherwise, we are used to just doing the postures, learn the posture and practice the posture and perfect the posture. And we miss the yogic fabric. So this is how one of the very basic components of a yogic fabric in your practices. So just as we can be exercising our body, mind, breath in a position. Now if it is a difficult asana, you find difficulty in breath and breathing. In that case, it's an exercise to the breath. Even if you try to breathe very normally, in a difficult contortion, difficult intensity, hard intensity, then trying to breathe normal itself is an exercise. So there is also exercise coming to breath aspects, mind aspects, and body aspects. In yoga, we need to have a prominence to purificatory process. So in your asana, find out, we need to go for purificatory processes. Exhalation is a very important instrument to be purifying the cellular body, corporeal body, empirical mind, temporal mind, and perhaps at a later stage a deeper mind, as well as deeper body and esoteric body. So in every asana, make it a point to exhale more and more and more and more and more often. This will work on cellular plane, which you can testify yourself by exhaling more and more and more in the head segment, brain segment, to pelvic segment. So try to experience, when you exhale unusual volume of exhalation, it will be kind of internal excretion, internal evacuation, internal purification. Because classical yoga postulates that there must be purificatory process in place in whatever aspect of yoga is being practiced. So find out how you can have purificatory process in your posture and position that you are having. Hereafter, we should dare not call this as a posture, because there are so many things taking place. Mind, body, breath, they are addressing, they are addressed, they are used, they are applied, they are applying. So it doesn't justify to call these as postures. Now, purificatory aspect is one aspect of classical yoga. The other one is knowledge aspect. If you look at the sutra, second chapter 28 sutra, which describes about Ashtanga yoga, yoganga anushthanat ashuddhikshaye jnanadeeptihi avivega khyatehe. So there are two aspects. One is purificatory process, cleansing process, and the other one is knowledge process. So when you are having your awareness, when you are having your mental act, intellectual act, emotional act, psychological act, mental act, psychic act, and it's a knowledge in the realm of the internal world. You are doing everything with awareness, you are doing everything with sensitivity, and therefore there is perception, there is cognition, and therefore there is knowledge process as well. So you can identify that there is both purificatory process and knowledge process as prescribed by Patanjali in his Ashtanga Yoga Sutra. And of course it is implied yoga is a purificatory process, yoga is a knowledge process. So see how there is a knowledge process. Therefore there is education. You learn about your body, mind, breath. You learn about the interactions of body, mind, and breath. You learn about interplay of body, mind, and breath. You understand how they can work for each other. They are working for each other. Your body is not working for you. Your mind is not working for you. The breath is not working for you. They are working for each other. Their interaction. So there is enormous internal community culture, internal social condition, social interaction, and therefore it's an internal sociological act which is taking place between your body matter, mind matters, and breath matters. So that is one of the fabrics of classical yoga which you can start exploring, identifying, discovering in any position that you are. So you can try various postures, various positions, and see how this precept can be applied, and then you can see how education is coming in place. Now comes the conclusive note. After this kind of educative session, a short session that I gave you, now today we are all under a tremendous gravity of this coronavirus. The whole world is tensed, stressed, petrified. And Therefore, let me give few words about this. Now, in present situation, what everyone is longing is that one is longing for having good immunity, because we don't have any medicine on corona so far. So there is no remedy, there is no medicine discovered yet. So we all are going to depend upon our immunity, and we want our immunity to be well on surface and on toes. We want our immunity system to be on toes. In the yogic perspective, let me tell you here, the immunity depends upon two factors. That one is that your organic system, physiological system, more particularly the belly, the abdomen, which is abdominal, which is organic complex, the abdominal organs should function well. They must optimally function. If they are not functioning optimally, then we are vulnerable to get infected, get any kind of infection, either bacterial or even viral. So the abdominal organs must be considered as a primary factor, because they have a defense mechanism which is important in immunity system. So in asanas, in any posture, any position which you now perhaps did, try to understand how much you addressed your belly, how much you could address the belly, how much you address the belly, how much you could address the abdominal organs, how much did you address, how much can you address, progressively how you can improve the addressal to abdomen, participation of abdomen in your posture, addressal of abdomen in your posture, involvement of your abdominal organs in the posture. So using, addressing, involving, making abdomen participate, making the abdomen to be recipient. This is a very important aspects of dimension, the dimension of asanas, which will work on your abdominal organs, belly organs, and therefore that aspect of being vulnerable to any disease or infections will be kept at bay. So abdominal organs must be in a good condition. So just as we say we must eat fresh food and good food, etc., during such times, and we are doing it, we are trying to keep our food free from any junk food. We are free from junk food, fast food, food from outside hotels and restaurants. So we are in homely food, so that is taking care. It is not that we only eat good food. It works on the belly, and belly works on it. So when it works on belly works on it, it builds up our immune system. So that's about physiological dimension of immunity problem that you are facing today. The second one is mind, the brain, mind organ, psychological organ. The brain, if it is under a lot of tension, stress, worry, anxiety, or any malaise, etc., that is going to be counterproductive. That is going to not work for our immunity system positively. It's going to work negatively. So those who have turbulent mind, very rarely they have good system, defense system. If they have it, it is by default, it is by some chance, it is by their luck that somebody is unhealthy in the mind but at the end healthy in the body. So it is it's a fortunate thing. It is by luck, it is by default. Usually, logically, the brain function and the metabolism, the brain function and immunity process go hand in hand. So we must have a sound brain process, mind process, psychological process, mental process. We must be at ease, we must be distensed. Rather than being tensed, we must be distensed. We must be de-stressed rather than be distressed. So we have to understand the difference between distress and de-stress. So we should go for de-stressed condition. And in asanas, when you go for addressing the head, brain, face, skull, you are addressing your psychological mind. You are addressing your psycho-mental mind, psychic mind. So the mind will be kept in a good state, a stable state without any symptoms of malaise or activity of malaise, mind will be quiet and serene. So addressing the brain in every asana is so important, as much as it is abdomen, which I said earlier. So we can only now try to reinforce our immunity system by addressing your abdomen by proper food, addressing the abdomen by our postures, which you call as postures or asanas, so also the brain, address the brain. See, we are interacting within yourself. When you interact within yourself in yoga, do you see, have a condition that you don't like you or you like you? You love you or you hate you? So we are having interaction where there is no love or hate. There is no condition of attachment, aversion when we interact within ourselves. This is a very important field of work. So within us, we can get a field of work where there is no attachment, no aversion, no like, no dislike, no distaste, no love, no fondness. So within ourselves, when we work, we keep all these dualities at bay. Love and hate, like and dislike. And that's a, this is a unique field for the brain, for the mind, that it is not working under any gravities. This is also important to build up immune system. If your mind is oscillating in all polarities, attachment, aversions, like, dislike, love, loathe, then it will not reinforce the immunity system. In asanas, we can address the brain. They can use the brain, address the brain internally, where there is no, it's no field for attachment, aversion, gravities. No field for gravity of likes and dislikes. No field for gravity of love and loathe. Is that not a saintly mindset? So asanas give us a field to have such a mindset. Therefore, immunity aspect will be taken care of by these practices. Finally, let me tell you, immunity is not a pill that you can swallow and you get it. It is a metabolic process. It is a body chemistry process. So there is no instant measure for having immunity. You can take some supplements in vitamins and proteins and calciums, minerals, etc. You can't have any supplementary for this. So metabolism turns it out. So it's a process. It's a physiological process. It is a cellular metabolical process. And it is a biochemical process. Don't expect something like pill of immunity. No asana is a pill of immunity. Whatever asanas you are doing, they can work for immunity. Immunity is something that is developed in long run. It is not something that can be had in short-term basis, short-run basis. So this is our system, and the chemistry of us will generate something which gives us immunity system. So let me tell you, don't get carried away. You will have so many things coming on mass media. Do this asana, good for immunity. Good this pranayama, good for immunity. It is really fooling, because it has to work in our system. So it works, takes a longer time. Like a child takes 9 months to take birth, similarly, immunity is something like that. And therefore, it will be by our biochemistry improving and our cellular metabolism improving. There is no short-term measure. There is no pill. No pranayama is a pill to immunity. No asana is pill. No kriya of yoga is a pill. So understand this. Continue with this kind of practice with this perspective, the classical fabric which I introduced. You will certainly work on that front as well. Thank you.
Namaskar.